In this video, you'll see how to deploy Amazon WorkSpaces in bulk. With the AWS Service Catalog Bulk Deployer, you can simplify desktop delivery to your remote workforce, reduce costs spent on desktop and laptop resources, and rapidly provision and scale deployments. We'll start off in a GitHub repository that contains the AWS Service Catalog reference architecture needed to deploy WorkSpaces in bulk. This repo enables all the necessary components required to provision any number of WorkSpaces at scale. Let's take a look at the documentation. You'll need a comma-separated value file, or CSV file, containing information on all the workspaces you want to provision, in this format. In this case, we already have our CSV file ready to go. As you can see, we'll be deploying two workspaces, but we can just as easily deploy 200 or 2,000 workspaces using the same method. Let's continue. Launching this stack will install all the components needed to bulk provision your workspaces. For the purposes of this demonstration, we have already done this. Let's take a quick look at the main components. From our GitHub repo, we have created several CloudFormation stacks that will be required for bulk provisioning. We also have two products created in AWS Service Catalog. We'll be using the Start Bulk Deploy Workspace product to kick off the bulk provisioning in just a moment. Our workspaces will appear here once they've been provisioned. An Amazon Simple Storage Service, or Amazon S3 bucket, was also created. To facilitate the bulk provisioning process, our CSV file needs to be placed inside the bucket. For our purposes, the CSV file has already been added. Let's drill down into it. We'll take the object URL and copy it to the clipboard. Next, let's navigate back to our Service Catalog products to start the deployment. We'll launch the Start Bulk Deploy Workspace product. We can enter a provisioned product name or generate one. Let's generate a name and then review our parameters. Let's paste in the object URL we copied earlier to specify which S3 bucket our CSV file is in. We'll remove the last part of the URL, retaining only the S3 bucket name. Let's paste the same URL into the key field and then remove everything but the key name. Next, let's input the batch name and specify an email for reporting. Now we can launch the product. Now that the bulk workspaces have started provisioning, the environment will change a bit. For example, we can see three more CloudFormation stacks, including one for each of the two users we specified in our CSV file. Let's refresh our workspaces. As you can see, two new workspaces are pending. Finally, let's navigate to Service Catalog and take a look at the provisioned products for our account. Notice that there are two new products in our environment. Our provisioned products are now available and ready to go. Let's check our workspaces again. As you can see, the new workspaces are now ready as well. Let's check DynamoDB to ensure our table provisioned correctly. Everything looks as it should. Finally, let's check out our newly created CloudFormation stacks. We'll drill into one to verify that everything from the CSV file carried through correctly. As you can see, the text file and CSV file match up. You've just seen how to provision and deploy Amazon Workspaces in bulk. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.